I'm George and I play a guitar.
So no one told you life was going to be this way, your job's a joke, you're broke, your love life's DOA. It's like you're always stuck in second gear when it hasn't been your day, your week, your month or even your year. For you, I'll be there for you, I'll be there for you.
Yes, yes, it's time for another somewhat quirky thing or moment with just enough clickbait to make 5 to 10 minutes of content. I love the Beatles. You know, I think they're just the bee's knees. You know, some people say they're overrated, but I actually go the opposite direction. I think they're underrated. You know, I reckon they should just be like a single channel on TV dedicated to broadcasting their music 24/7. I think that citizens should have their social credit score that's directly tied to their knowledge of the Beatles. You know, yeah. What's that? You didn't know that Love Me Do was their first single released? I'm sorry, mate. Now you can't afford a house, and your kids have to go to another school. Because I think that's completely fair. Big Beatles fan. But one thing you might not know about the Beatles is how they very nearly saved Middle Earth from the dark forces of Sauron. This is the story of when the Beatles... Fuck me, that's clipped. Jesus, look at that. This is the story of how the Beatles very nearly saved Middle-earth from the dark forces of Sauron, and now there is no distortion, because this is a good microphone, yes. This is the story of when the Beatles very nearly made the first Lord of the Rings film. Our story begins with a hole in the ground where there lived a beetle. Not a nasty, dirty, wet hole filled with, you know, the ends of worms and an oozy smell. Nor yet a dry, bare, sandy hole with nothing in it to sit down on or to eat. It was a beetle hole, and that means comfort. And when a beetle has comfort, they also have the ability to do whatever they want. This happened when the Beatles were relaxing in their very infamous trip to India in 1968, when Dennis O'Dell, the head of the Beatles' own production company, visited them with copies of the book. He was hoping to create a Beatles Lord of the Rings, you know, quote-unquote, multimedia musical extravaganza, which sounds incredible. And the Beatles, you know, they thought it was a real humdinger, just a proper old doozy of an idea. So what would the film be? It would be a musical spectacular. Dancing, singing, potatoes, just the whole work.
I've heard that the Beatles actually wanted to make the Lord of the Rings movie. Mm-hmm. And as someone who made the definitive Lord of the Rings movie and now has spent all these years with the Beatles in such an intimate way, how would you cast John, Paul, George, and Ringo if you were to make the Lord of the Rings again? Would you make them the Hobbits?
Well, I mean, I like the idea. I mean, obviously, Paul Frodo, isn't he? I mean, it says, are we talking about Lord of the Rings? Here we are. Okay. Not what I thought this conversation would be. Okay, Paul is obviously Frodo. I mean, you get to... And Sam is obviously Ringo, isn't it? So then you've got...
Yes.
Well, John's Gollum, isn't he? He is, and George is... They cast themselves, and they did it right. Gandalf, you know, George, the mystic magician, that's perfect. I mean, we have to age him up a bit. And I guess if you had to have Gollum and you had the four Beatles, John Lennon is the obvious one, isn't he? Absolutely, Sam Dunk.
Frodo would be played by Paul, Sam would be played by Ringo, Gandalf would obviously be George, and of course, this goes without saying, that Gollum would obviously be played by John Lennon. That just goes without saying. They also wanted to bring in a lot of their friends to play the, you know, supporting roles. So Galadriel, which is a name that's very difficult to pronounce in my accent, would have been played by the supermodel Twiggy. Mary would be played by their fellow musician Donovan. No, not Conovan, because he's a fantastic YouTuber that you should watch more of. Donovan, the musician. And then what we have to ask is, well, who would direct it? Well, Stanley Kubrick, of course.
It's murder. I can't do it. Can't keep it up.
Our life is so precious.
Rubbish. You're too fat. You need exercise.
Come on, you cunt.
Now, you're probably thinking to yourself, well, that's all good and all. Why don't I have footage of a half-naked John Lennon eating a raw fish from a lake? Well, that's because, unfortunately, it never came into fruition. When Stanley Kubrick was proposed with the idea, he thought it was absolutely brilliant. Truly just a cinematic masterpiece waiting to happen. But ultimately, he turned it down because he knew that it wasn't feasible to, you know, film such an ambitious story as Lord of the Rings. Unfortunately, he decided to spend his time producing the film 2001 A Space Odyssey instead, which I think is just a real loss in the art of filmmaking. I mean, you know, 2001 isn't bad, but it's no George Harrison holding a large wooden stick fighting a man dressed as Balrog, is it? And it also really fell apart just given that J.R.R. Tolkien was completely against the idea. At this point in time, he still owned the film rights to Lord of the Rings, which meant that it was just impossible for the Beatles to produce a film adaptation without his consent. And as it turns out, the 72-year-old English academic was not particularly fond of rock bands, as it would seem. Or in fact, it seems that he was not particularly fond of loud noises in general. And we know this due to a letter that he wrote to a friend in 1964, where he talks about noise pollution, of all things. Dear Bretherton, I typed out The Hobbit and the whole Lord of the Rings twice, and several sections many times, in my bed in an attic of Manor Road, in the dark days between the loss of my house in North Oxford, which I could no longer afford, and my brief elevation to the dignity of an old college house in Holywell. But Headingston is no paradise of peace. Now it is a car park for the field of Oxford United at the top end. While the actual inhabitants do all that radio, telly, dogs, scooters, buzz bikes, and cars of all sizes but the smallest can do to produce noise from early morn to about 2 a.m. In addition, in a house 3 doors away dwells a member of a group of young men who are evidently aiming to turn themselves into a Beatle group on days when it falls to his... fucking hell. On days when it falls to his turn to have a practice session, the noise is indescribable. Am I suggesting that Tolkien turned down a film adaptation simply because he didn't like the noise coming from his next-door neighbor's garage band? Yes. Yes, I am.
You guys try to do Lord of the Rings?
We didn't.
What's the story on that?
Yeah, we read the book and we approached Tolkien about it because we thought it'd be a very exciting thing because there were 4 main characters in there that we could have played. But Tolkien didn't want us to. And he blocked it. I'm not sure how great a job we would have done on it. It's such a big thing to do. It needs to be approached like they've approached it, you know, on a sort of mammoth scale. And anyway, Tolkien blocked us, so there.
So there. Okay,
hey,
why not?
Sorry, Mr. Tolkien, you don't like the Beatles.
Well, that's that. Several years later, the Beatles got their wish to see The Lord of the Rings on the big screen, but unfortunately they weren't a part of it. As we all know, this culminated in one of the greatest film experiences in cinema history, which is the 1978 animated Lord of the Rings film. Anyway, thank you for watching, please subscribe, and thank you.
And I'd just like to say, we hate you all, you little scrub scab.